नमस्कार, आइकोनिक एड मिडियाको उत्पादन कार्यक्रम स्टडी लिङ्कमा यहाँहरूलाई हार्दिक स्वागत छ। म सृजना थापा। यो कार्यक्रम यहाँहरूले हरेक साताको शुक्रबार बेलुकी 36 र पुनः प्रसारण शनिबार दिउँसो 12:05 हेर्न सक्नुहुनेछ।
This program is supported by Chelsea International Academy, Rakachor Mark, Midbaneswar, Elixir Academy, Kariboat, Kumarigal, CZ Institute of Management, Achaudhuri Group Initiative, St. Lawrence College, Chabahil, The Light School Aid, Senior Secondary Boarding School, Manjushri Bazar Marga, Swayambhu, Pentagon International College, Tinkune, Kavya School, New Baneswar, NASA International College, Gairigaon, Eastwell Higher Secondary School, Gokarneswar, Jorpati, Reliance International Academy, Saraswati Nagar, Chabahil, Prime College, Khushibu, Naya Bazar, Everest International College, Soltimod, Golden Gate International College, Battisputali, Arunima Educational Foundation, Bauda, Kathmandu, Academy of Commerce, Ramsahapat, Putalisarak.
Committed to total personality development, Arunima nurtures the nature to ensure the future. We offer excellent results, modern infrastructure and facilities, skillful professionals and a plethora of activities. Your child feels at home. Arunima Secondary School, Bauda. Nava Arunima Secondary School, Arubadi. Arunima Shisu Sadan Secondary School, Mahankal.
दर्शकवृन्द, यो साता पुरै मुलुक निर्वाचनमय बन्यो। प्रदेश नम्बर 3, 4 र 6 भएको पहिलो चरणको स्थानीय तह निर्वाचनले गर्दा यो साता कुनै पनि शैक्षिक गतिविधिहरू भएनन्। निर्वाचन र मतगणनाका कारण यो साता पुरै निर्वाचन बन्न पुगेको हो। चौसे इन्टरनेसनलले केही साता अघि काठमाडौँमा ए लेभलका विद्यार्थी बीच विशेष अन्तर्क्रियाको आयोजना गरेको थियो। स्टडी लिङ्कको पहिलो प्रस्तुतिमा त्यही अन्तर्क्रियाको मुख्य अंश।
Ladies and gentlemen, warm greetings to you all. Today on this glorious day, I'm here along with other A-level students from Chelsea International Academy who performed admirably in the recent examinations that took place in the 2016 series of examinations conducted by Cambridge International Examinations. So firstly, I'd like to start with what A-levels is all about. So today I'm here with distinguished performers in the October-November 2016 series of examinations, as well as the May-June 2016 series of examinations. And firstly, I'd like to start with why choose A-levels, and to answer this question, I'd like to call upon Avash.
First thing that's very important about an A-levels curriculum is understanding that it facilitates change, and it is an active supporter of change. It's not something that will just sit back and tell you, okay, you need to improve. They improve along with you to like sort of facilitate that journey even further. So that's the first thing I think that it's very important for us to understand when it comes to choosing the A-levels curriculum, that you're committing to, you know, constantly changing and constantly evolving. I think that's the first thing you need to know. The second thing is a commitment to community service, because I think that's something that's an almost unwritten rule. You have to do, like, you know, certain hours of community service in order for you to graduate. So this is an attempt, I think, from the A-levels curriculum to get us to sort of communicate with the society at large and sort of make us recognize what our responsibility is towards the society. So it's some form of communal service that they want us to do in order for us to identify better with and sort of, you know, feel a part of society. So I think that's the second thing that an A-levels curriculum sort of tries to give you, and I think that's very important to know as well. I think more ideas start to develop within a certain subsect of study, then we have more opinions coming in for like progressing years.
So to further continue the discussion, I'd like to ask Bishrut, what does it take to do well in A-levels examinations, and how did you do it?
The A-levels curriculum is designed in a way that it promotes continuous learning. You need to understand each concept as it is taught in order for you to, you know, complement later understanding of, you know, subject topics that come later in the syllabus. Keeping up with all the homework, firstly, of course, but also consolidating that with, you know, outside research. So especially for stuff like economics and business, which I really enjoyed, when it comes to preparing for examinations and doing well, I'd say that the number one key thing you have to keep in mind is that it's not about cramming, it's about continuous learning And it's about linking the ideas you learn in the classroom to things you see around you in everyday life.
I'd like to now talk to Anup, and I'd like to ask him, are the extracurricular activities that are offered by taking part in A-levels?
As a global subject course, A-levels teaches you about more about how you can use the subject matters in the practical life of yours. So basically, this means there are going to be many extracurricular activities such as debating, interacting with other international students, and taking part in competitions all around the globe, so that you will develop a kind of competitive nature. A-levels provides sufficient time for proper studies as well as the extracurricular activities to excel for the student to grow, not just mentally but physically as well.
The amount of knowledge that you gain is also contingent on the amount of extracurricular activities that you take part in. So moving on, I'd like to talk about how A-levels is in regards to science, and to do this I'd like to talk to Prajwal.
First thing you learn about A-level science is that it's fully practical based. You have a practical paper to itself, and even in AS and both A-levels, the practical application is one of the essential part of the A-level learning. Yes, it is very much vigorous as any other fields of science. One of the most important applications about science is that the theory that you're learning about is going to be used in the laboratory. Whatever is going to appear in the exam, the questions that are going to appear in the exam, you are only able to do that if you fully understand the theory. So you cannot just learn a formula and be able to answer the questions. You should be able to know the applications of the formula. You should be able to know how the formula arrived at the point that it is.
So to continue the discussion, I'd like to talk about our institution, Chelsea International Academy in particular. And to do this and to talk about the kind of student community that we have in our college and the high achievers that we have in our college, I'd like to call upon Bishrut.
Chelsea has a relatively small community, but even that small community is very diverse. You have people coming in from all parts of Nepal, all parts of the valley, and you know, in some cases like myself, right, so I did my schooling in Australia, I found that, you know, the small size of the college meant that, you know, the attention we got from teachers, the speed at which we were able to build connections within ourselves was simply astounding. You know, the environment that Chelsea provides with its library, with its classrooms, with its small class sizes is really unmatched, I think, by any other institution. The level of focus we get, I think, really is actually key to the consistent level of performance that Chelsea has shown when it comes to garnering excellent grades in the examinations as well.
To tell us about what type of extracurricular activities are offered by Chelsea International Academy, I'd like to call upon Avash.
So I think it's very important for us to recognize that within the A-levels community in Nepal, and maybe within just Nepal in general, Chelsea has always been a pioneer of extracurricular activities. So if you consider something like, let's say, debating, for instance, because I talked about it a lot earlier. So the first parliamentary debate tournament ever that happened in Nepal was organized by Chelsea. So it was the Chelsea Debate Fest that happened in 2010. And it's interesting to note that within the field of debating, Chelsea has been the most successful institution in the country. Not only are we a pioneer in terms of introducing new things to the community, but we're also very good at maintaining standards. In Chelsea, we try to maintain a certain level of standard when it comes to the ECS that we organize.
It speaks volumes about the level of quality that we have at Chelsea, that we are able to take part in so many extracurricular activities, how they felt when they learned that they have achieved such great marks in their examinations. So to start off with that, I'd like to ask Anup how he felt when he found out that he topped the country in business studies.
Frankly speaking, the feeling of getting the award was truly like life-changing kind of for me, because it was always a dream for me to get something like this in the national level. There were awardees like who got awards for international recognitions, achieving different successes in different subject materials. How does A-levels kind of help you? And I even communicate with all the toppers that Chelsea has achieved throughout its history. They really give an inspiration and kind of tips such as try to keep the subject materials close to your personal life rather than just using a day before to mug up all subject materials.
Now we're going to talk about some of the potential drawbacks that has been mentioned in society, that has been spreading in the community, and that has resulted in a very few amount of students pursuing A-levels as their further education after doing their SLCs or their SEEs. Why these drawbacks are not that significant, I'd like to call upon Avash.
So it's very important for us to note that, first of all, there are a very few number of people that are doing the A-levels. We have, I think, 2,000 people or something around that number. The first thing that's very important for us to note is that A-levels is self-selective. That is, of the hundreds of thousands of people that give their SEE exams, only a few care enough about A-levels to apply there. And these are people that are, in many cases, academically inclined and, you know, wanting that form of challenge. So the reason why the pool is so small is not because of things like it being incompatible with the Nepali syllabus when you go on to like undergrad, or because people just want to go abroad. It's because it's a very challenging curriculum and people recognize that. Second is that A-level degrees are recognized worldwide. More than 170 countries accept A-level degrees. And among those countries is also Nepal. So in fact, I'd argue that the A-levels graduates from Nepali schools that go and study in Nepali universities actually do a lot better than people from other curriculums. Finally, I also want to address this issue of the A-levels being too hard and people dropping out. I think it's important to recognize that when you're doing the A-levels, regardless of which school you're doing it in, because it's very different from the approach that we have in the SEE curriculum, it's hard for some people to adjust. So it's not a matter of it being too hard. It's simply that up to the SEE curriculum, in many cases, we were spoon-fed with answers. And now we're not spoon-fed. We're asked to work with ourselves. And yes, it's hard, but I think that it helps us better prepare for life after high school.
So at the end of the talk, we have come up with these points. We've come up with the fact that A-levels is practical, it helps in in-depth understanding, and it is by far a better choice for your future. We've addressed some of the pitfalls that are normally associated with A-level curriculums, and we've also talked about our institution and also about the personal feelings that I hope that this talk will help persuade our viewers to take part in A-level studies in the future.
This part of the program is supported by AACC Global. We are proud of our visa success. Charkhal Dili Bazar. Presidential Business School, a truly American business school, Tapagao. CZ Institute of Management, a Chowdhury Group initiative. Trizoti Higher Secondary School, Faika Kapan. Rit Academy, Plus 2 Law Management, Basundara Chowki. Pioneer International Public School, Kapan, Akasadhara Neil Handball Ground. Universal Higher Secondary School, Tumbarai. Whiteville Higher Secondary School, Khushibu. Jaya Multiple Campus, Manakamna Higher Secondary School, Gokaneswar, Jorpati. Joseph High School, Kapan, Milancho. Lumbini Academic College, Chabahil, Chuchipati. Xavier Academy, the institution that cares, Lazimpat.
Protecting your future. Fire insurance, motor insurance, marine cargo insurance, personal accident insurance, travel insurance, engineering and contractors all risk insurance, aviation insurance, micro insurance, and the other insurance. Protecting your future with Prabhu Insurance.
दर्शकवृन्द, अभिभावकहरू सधैँ उत्कृष्ट कलेजको खोजीमा रहन्छन्। उनीहरू आफ्ना छोराछोरीमा शैक्षिक ज्ञान मात्र नभई अनुशासित जीवनशैलीको अपेक्षा पनि गर्दछन्। अभिभावकको यही अपेक्षालाई सम्बोधन गर्दै बिबिए पठन पाठन गर्दै आएको ललितपुरको सिटिजन कलेजले टुरिज्म सम्बन्धी कोर्सको तयारी पनि गरेको छ। पोखरा विश्वविद्यालयबाट सम्बन्धन प्राप्त सिटिजन कलेजका प्रिन्सिपल हरिकृष्ण अर्यालसँगको कुराकानी अबको प्रस्तुतिमा।
सिटिजन कलेजको अब यो नयाँ तयारीहरू के छन्? अहिले नयाँ सत्र लागेको छ।
विशेष गरी सिटिजन कलेज 2009 इस्टाब्लिस कलेज हो र यो पोखरा युनिभर्सिटीमा निकै नै अब्बल स्थानमा हामी दुईवटा कारणले माथि छौँ। एउटा चाहिँ नि विद्यार्थीहरूको परीक्षा फल हेर्दाखेरि हामी साह्रै नै उत्कृष्ट लेभलमा छौँ र हामीले यही बिचमा पनि धेरै कामहरू गरेका छौँ। जस्तो हामीले बिबिएको शिक्षालाई मात्रै राखिराख्दा केही कुराहरू अरू थप्नुपर्ने भएको कारणले गर्दाखेरि अहिले हामीले भर्खरै बिबिए टिटी ट्राभल एन्ड टुरिज्म र बिसिए ब्याचलर इन कम्प्युटर एप्लिकेसन्सको प्रोग्रामहरू पनि यही सेसनदेखि हामीहरू सञ्चालन गर्ने गरी अगाडि बढिरहेका छौँ। र विशेष गरी भन्नुपर्दा यो हाम्रो सिटिजन कलेज क्वालिटेटिभ स्टुडेन्ट्सहरू र चाहिँ हाइली एक्सपिरियन्स्ड टिचरहरूको एउटा साह्रै मिठो सङ्गम स्थल हो। त्यस कारणले गर्दाखेरि पनि यहाँ हाम्रा जुन विद्यार्थीहरू आउँछन् जुन उसले उनले एकदम लगनशीलताका साथ मेहनत गरेर आफ्नो काम गर्दछन् र यहाँ हाम्रोमा तडक भडक हुँदैन। सबैभन्दा ठुलो कुरा प्राइभेट इन्स्टिच्युटमा गाह्रो कुरा के हुँदो रहेछ भने 4-5 लाख रुपियाँ अथवा 6-7 लाख रुपियाँ तिरेर कुनै विद्यार्थीले पढ्छ भने उसले एउटा सो अप गर्ने कुरा गर्ने पनि कुनै कुनै ठाउँमा मैले भेटेको छु।
तपाईँले भन्न खोज्नु भएको शिक्षा सँगसँगै हामी अनुशासन नैतिकता पनि सिकाइरहेछौँ भन्न खोज्छौँ।
एकदमै सर,
त्यो त कलेजहरूको एकदम अनिवार्य कामै हो, होइन?
अनिवार्य काम हो, तर पनि के रहेछ भने सर, यहाँ ब्याचलर पढ्ने विद्यार्थीलाई चाहिँ नि 8-9 कक्षामा अथवा 2-3 कक्षामा पढ्ने जस्तो गरेर हामीहरूले मेन्टोरिङ पनि गर्न सक्दैनौँ। नैतिक शिक्षाको कुरा गर्दा हामीसँग विद्यार्थी जम्मा 4 घन्टा हुन्छ र 18-20 घन्टा चाहिँ नि ऊ हामीभन्दा बाहिर हुन्छ। यो बेलामा विद्यार्थीलाई राख्नु, विद्यार्थीलाई अनुशासनमा राख्नु निकै गाह्रो कुरा छ। त्यस कारणले गर्दा हामीले विद्यार्थीलाई भर्ना गर्दा नै दुईवटा कुराको कमिटमेन्ट गरेका हुन्छ। एउटा एकाडेमिक्समा हामी कम्प्रोमाइज गर्दैनौँ, दोस्रो कुरा डिसिप्लिनमा कम्प्रोमाइज गर्दैनौँ।
तपाईँहरू जुन काममा लागिरहनु भएको छ, विद्यार्थीहरूलाई अध्ययन पनि गराउने र अनुशासन पनि सँगसँगै अगाडि बढाउने, नैतिकवान पनि बनाउने, त्यसमा कतिको सफल भएको अनुभव गर्नुभएको छ?
यसमा हामीले निकै नै सफल भएको देखिन्छ। किन देखिन्छ भने हामीहरूले विद्यार्थीहरूलाई यति धेरै एक्टिभिटिजहरूमा इन्भल्भ गराउँछौँ कि जसको कारणले गर्दा विद्यार्थीहरूले दायाँमा सोच्नै पाउँदैन। जस्तो हामी रिसर्च गराउँछौँ, रिसर्च वर्कमा गर्छौँ, प्रोजेक्ट वर्क गरिरहेको हुन्छ, उनीहरूको प्रेजेन्टेसन हुन्छ, असाइनमेन्ट हुन्छ, उनीहरूलाई यति धेरै इन्भल्भ गराउँछौँ कि जसको कारणले गर्दाखेरि विद्यार्थी उसले पढाएको भन्दा र चाहिँ नि यो समसामयिक दुनियाँलाई कसरी बुझ्ने भन्ने कुरामा बुझ्दा बुझ्दा उसले अन्य नकारात्मक गतिविधिहरू गर्न नपाउँदो रहेछ। त्यस कारणले गर्दाखेरि विद्यार्थीहरू हामीबाट यहाँ हुँदाखेरि विद्यार्थीहरू अलिकति चाहिँ नि अप्ठ्यारो मान्ने, इरिटेसन पनि मान्ने, किन भन्दा धेरै काम गर्नुपर्ने भएको कारणले। तर जब चाहिँ मार्केटमा जान्छ र मार्केटमा गइसकेपछि आफूलाई चाहिँ उसले यो अरू मानिसहरूसँग, अरू कलेजहरूबाट आएका विद्यार्थीहरूसँग कम्पिटिसन गर्दाखेरि आफूलाई निकै अब्बल दर्जामा ठान्दाखेरि हामीले आएर त्यतिखेर चाहिँ उनीहरूले हामीलाई साह्रै एप्रिसिएट गरेको हामीले भेटेका छौँ।
हरिकृष्ण सर, अब तपाईँ लामो समयदेखि यो शिक्षा क्षेत्रमा हुनुहुन्छ, नेपालका युवाहरू जो पढ्ने सन्दर्भमा, रोजगारीका सन्दर्भमा विदेश गइरहेका छन्, तिनीहरूलाई रोक्नलाई चाहिँ कस्तो शिक्षा आवश्यक छ र के गर्नुपर्छ भन्ने लाग्छ तपाईँलाई?
हामीले मान्छेहरूको एउटा चाहिँ सबैभन्दा पहिला चाहिँ नि मान्छेहरूको पर्सेप्सनको कुरा आउँछ। हामीले पर्सेप्सनलाई कसरी चेन्ज गर्ने भन्ने मुख्य कुरा। जस्तो हामीसँग पढ्ने विद्यार्थीको बिबिए र अस्ट्रेलियामा पढ्ने बिबिए एउटै बिबिए हो सर, तर मान्छे चाहिँ नि अस्ट्रेलिया जान चाहन्छ। यो किन जान चाहन्छ, उसले के पाउँछ भन्ने कुरा हामीहरूले विद्यार्थीले त्यो कुरा बुझेकै हुँदैन। बुवा आमाले पनि छोराछोरीलाई चाहिँ बाहिर पठायो भनेदेखिलाई अलिकति आफूलाई चाहिँ प्राउड फिल गर्ने, त्यो सोसाइटी हाम्रो चाहिँ डेभलप गरेका छौँ कि, यो सोसाइटीको रूपरेखा नै त्यस्तो भएको छ कि। अब यसको मिनिङ यो होइन कि तपाईँले यसो हेर्नुभयो भनेदेखिलाई हाम्रो नेपालको हाम्रै युनिभर्सिटीमा पढेर गएका विद्यार्थीहरू, हाम्रै प्लस टूमा पढेर गएका विद्यार्थीहरू, हाम्रै चाहिँ सरकारी स्कुलमा पढेर गएका विद्यार्थीहरूले बाहिर चाहिँ तपाईँले इन्टरनेसनल लेभलमा हार्वर्ड स्टडीमा जाँदाखेरि उसले धेरै राम्रो गरेका छन्, अब्बल दर्जामा काम गरेका छन्, तर उनीहरूले गरेको काम र चाहिँ बाहिर गएर सिकेर आएको मान्छे बिचमा त्यत्रो फरक नै होइन. त्यो एउटा मान्छेहरूको पर्सेप्सन के छ भने बाहिर गयो भने धन कमाउने एउटा चाहिँ नि थर्ड वर्ल्ड देख्ने भन्ने एउटा त्यो मान्छेको मेन्टालिटी एउटा पर्सेप्सन छ नि सर. त्यो पर्सेप्सनले पनि हो हामीले पढाउने बिबिए अहिले उसमा एलमा पढाउने एल युनिभर्सिटीमा पढाउने अक्सफोर्ड युनिभर्सिटीमा पढाउने जुन कोर्स छ त्यो कुरा हामीले पढिरहेका छौँ. अहिले इन्टरनेटको व्यवस्था छ सबै कुराहरू हामीसँग छ तर पनि मान्छेको एउटा एटिट्युड मान्छेको पर्सेप्सन र यो सोसाइटल ब्रोड एस्पेक्ट छ नि त्यो एस्पेक्ट नै के छ भन्नुहुन्छ भनेदेखिलाई बाहिर जाने बाहिर जानुपर्छ भन्ने एउटा त्यो मेन्टालिटी छ र चाहिँ त्यो जुनुन हुन्छ नि सर त्यो त्यसले मात्रै हो नि.
स्वदेशी विद्यार्थीलाई स्वदेशमै काम गरेर रोजगार गरेर स्वदेशमै सस्टेन हुनसक्ने अवस्था चाहिँ कतिको छ त्यो गर्नलाई सिटिजन कलेजले के गर्न सक्छ
सर? अब यसमा चाहिँ तपाईँले निकै मिठो कुरा गर्नुभयो. हामीहरूले चाहिँ नि विद्यार्थीहरू कोर्स पढेर मात्रै अथवा चाहिँ जागिर खानको लागि हामीहरूले पढाउँदैन. आफू उद्यमी बनेर जागिर दिनको लागि चाहिँ योग्य नागरिकहरू बनाउनको लागि हामीले काम गरिरहेका छौँ. कोर्समा ए र ए माइनस ल्याउनु मात्रै ठुलो कुरा होइन उनीहरूको सोचमा आमूल परिवर्तन गरिदिनको लागि डिफ्रेन्ट एरियाको चाहिँ स्कोपहरू देखाइदिने हाम्रो काम हो र त्यो गर्न सिटिजन कलेज सफल भएको छ. हामीले भनेको अथवा हामीले बनाएका प्रोजेक्ट्सहरूमा हामीले बोलाउँदाखेरि उहाँहरूको मिटिङमा र उहाँहरूसँग सेयर गर्दाखेरि जुन कुराहरू हुन्छ विद्यार्थीको चाहना बमोजिम छोराछोरीलाई हामीले के गर्नु तपाईँहरूले पनि हामीले जुन खालले उनीहरूलाई चाहिँ ब्रेमिङ गर्छौँ अथवा चाहिँ ब्रेन स्टोमिङ गरेर चाहिँ उनीहरूको पोटेन्सियालिटी यो भनेर भन्छौँ त्यसपछि उहाँहरूले पनि त्यही अनुसारको रूपरेखा तयार गरिदिनलाई काम गर्नुभएको छ.
हामी कार्यक्रमको अन्तिम आइपुगेका छौँ. म अन्तिममा सुन्न चाहन्छु जस्तो निजी कलेज चलाइरहन चाहिँ कतिको गाह्रो रहेछ प्रशासनिक झमेलाहरू कतिका छन् सरकारले हेर्ने दृष्टिकोण कस्तो छ?
एकातिरबाट भन्दा यो प्राइभेट इन्स्टिट्युसन चलाउँदा मजा पनि आउँछ. किन मजा आउँछ भनेदेखिलाई आज म सबैभन्दा ठुलो सेवकको रूपमा यहाँ छु. यो मेरो आफ्नै पनि कलेज हो. आज मैले लगानी गरेको छु. लगानी गरेको कारणले गर्दाखेरि एक दुईजना मानिसहरूलाई अहिले हामीसँग 41 टिचर्सहरू हुनुहुन्छ हामीसँग 12 स्टाफ्सहरू हुनुहुन्छ र हामीसँग जोडिएर आउने धेरै स्टेक होल्डर्सहरू हुनुहुन्छ. आज हामी कापी कलमहरू ल्याउँछौँ आज मार्कर बोर्डहरू ल्याउँछौँ आज धेरै कामहरू हुन्छ र चाहिँ एउटा देशको इकोनोमिक ग्रोथमा हामीले राम्रो योगदान पुर्याउन सकेका छौँ र जुनसुकै अवस्थामा पनि यति दिएनस् भने यस्तो गरेनस् भने म यो गरिदिन्छु यो रोकिदिन्छु भन्ने खालका झैझमेलाहरू यस्ता खालका अब्स्ट्याकल्सहरू आउँछन् र यो नेपालमा एउटा संस्कृति पनि बनेको छ. यो संस्कृतिलाई परिवर्तन गर्ने पनि हामीले हो. यसलाई स्वाभाविक रूपमा लिएर यी कुराहरू मिल्दै जान्छन् र यो कुराहरूलाई सबैले निरुत्साहित गर्दै जानुपर्छ र गरिन्छ. शिक्षा क्षेत्रमा सेवा पनि गरिरहेका छौँ. हामीले चाहिँ नि जागिर मात्रै खाइरहेका छैनौँ पैसा मात्रै कमाइरहेका छैनौँ. कहिलेकाहीँ मान्छेहरूले चाहिँ यहाँ फल्छ भन् जस्तो छ हामीले पैसा कमाउन सकिन्छ हामी बिपीमा चलिरहेका छौँ तर चाहिँ हामीले सोसाइटीमा एउटा असल नागरिक बनाउनको लागि
आत्मसन्तोष चाहिँ प्राप्त भएको छ
निकै ठुलो आत्मसन्तुष्टि.
यही आत्मसन्तोषलाई व्यावसायिक रूपमा पनि एकदमै ठुलो बनाउनु चाहिँ के गर्नु बाँकी छ अब?
यसमा आमूल रूपमा त आफू मात्रै आफूभित्रै परिवर्तन हुनु पऱ्यो सर. त्यो फेरि कस्तो छ भनेदेखिलाई आत्मसन्तुष्टि पनि भोको पेटले आत्मसन्तुष्टि कति लामो समयसम्म रहने त्यो पनि एउटा महत्त्वपूर्ण विषय हो. तर हामीले प्रयत्न गर्दै जाँदाखेरि एउटा सकारात्मक सोच राखेर हामीहरूले यो एकाडेमिक सेक्टरमा अनबायस्ड भएर यो नातावाद कृपावाद भन्ने जस्ता कुराहरू छन् नि यो कुराबाट अलिकति हटेर निस्वार्थ रूपमा हामीले विद्यार्थीलाई जे कामको लागि हामीले जे भनेर जुन ओड दिएर हामीले विद्यार्थीलाई भर्ना गरेको हो उनीहरूले 4 यो कलेजबाट निस्किँदै गर्दा हामीले उनीहरूले भनेको भन्दा केही कुराहरू थप्न सक्यौँ भने र उनीहरूको मुहारमा कान्ति ल्याउन सक्यौँ भने कान्ति ल्याउनको लागि हामीले जे प्रयत्न गर्छौँ नि त्यही प्रयत्न नै आत्मसन्तुष्टि हुन्छ सर. 4 लागि विद्यार्थी ल्याउँदै गर्दा उसको 40 भविष्य सेक्योर गर्न सक्यो भने सर मैले यहाँ यस्तो काम गरेर आएको छु भनेर कुनै एउटा विद्यार्थीले 10 आएर भन्छ भने सबैभन्दा आत्मसन्तुष्टि त्यतिखेर मात्रै मापन गर्न सकिने होला सर. अहिले त अब यही गर्दाखेरि आत्मसन्तुष्टि आउँछ भनेर कसरी भन्नु?
धन्यवाद.
This program is supported by Pokhara University Affiliated Colleges, Uniglobe College, Nibaneswar, Novel College, Sinamangal, Rajdhani Model College, Old Baneswar, Central College of Business Management, Sinamangal, Citizen College, Sadhubato, Riz Hospitality Management College, Balkumari, Lalitpur. Quest International College, Gwarko, Lalitpur. Malpi International College, Balwatar. Apex College, Baneswar.
स्टडी लिङ्कको निर्धारित समय सकिएको छ। कार्यक्रमको बारेमा केही जिज्ञासा वा सुझाव भएमा इमेल मार्फत हामीलाई सम्पर्क गर्न सक्नुहुनेछ। अर्को साता यसै समयमा फेरि उपस्थित हुने नै छौँ। तबसम्मका लागि कार्यक्रम उत्पादनमा संलग्न सबै साथीहरूसँगै मलाई पनि बिदा दिनुहोस्। नमस्ते।